Linking the transparency of one layer to another layer is an effect called track matte. It opens up many doors to creativity in compositing, title animation, and more. So without further ado, let's see how to do it in After Effects. All right, we are in After Effects. I'm gonna create a comp for our track matte tutorial. 1920 by 1080, 30 FPS, 10 seconds, white, and let's go. Okay, now let's drag the footage into the comp. This is our psychedelic footage. We want to show this layer only through another layer, so I'll add another layer on top of this one. Nothing crazy, just a simple triangle. Now, in order to turn the triangle layer into the matte for the footage, we need to have access to the track matte options. So click on this icon here to open up the menu if it's not already opened. Here you can see that the track matte menu is only available for our footage layer. That's because the hierarchy of layers is important in this effect. So only the bottom layer can have the track matte effect because the top layer will be the matte itself. Two types of track matte effects are alpha matte, where the transparency of the bottom layer will be linked to the entire transparent area of the top layer, and the luma matte, where the transparency of the bottom layer will be linked to the luminosity of the top layer. I'm gonna start with alpha matte. You can see that the entire transparent area of the triangle is the channel to show the footage layer beneath it. We can also choose the alpha inverted matte option to invert the effect so the transparency will be anywhere except the triangle layer. So you can see the difference here if I switch it back. You can also add another layer behind your matte layer to create something like this. Now let's delete the other layers and try Luma Matte with this new footage. Here's a photo from Pixels. Let's import and resize it to fit the comp. It's a nice silhouette, perfect for the Luma Matte effect. Now when I choose the Luma Matte, you can see that there is a gradient in the transparency of the bottom layer, and that's because there is a gradient between the bright and dark areas in the top layer. Let's try the Luma Inverted Matte. Doesn't work. Oh, the layer is visible. That's why. So, like before, the inverted one inverts the effect. I mean, obviously. Now, there's another way to create the track matte effect without using the track matte menu and the limits of that. And that is by adding a set matte effect to the base layer. So, in this case, we add it to our footage layer. Here, I can choose which layer I want to be the matte for our footage layer. And the good thing is that it doesn't matter where the layer is in the timeline, as opposed to the previous way in which the matte layer should have been on top of the base layer. I can choose which channel of the matte layer I want to use for the effect, for example red, to only use red values for the track matte. You can see that there are different channels to choose from. And I can also choose whether the layer itself is the source or the mask and effects of it. So it basically gives you much more options compared to the previous way of applying the track matte, and doesn't matter where your layer is. One more cool thing that you can do with the set matte is that you don't have to turn off the matte layer. So you can use a layer while also having it as a matte layer. There are different ways to play with the image and get creative with it. So in general, set matte effect is a better way compared to the track matte panel, and that's the moral of the story. Thanks for watching. Now go and matte the hell out of it.